Sir Clive Sinclair, born the 30th of July 1940, is a British entrepreneur and inventor of the slimline electronic pocket calculator in 1972, Sinclair Executive, and the ZX80, ZX81 and ZX Spectrum. The ZX80 was the UK's first mass-market home computer for less than £100. Sinclair has been fascinated by electronics and miniaturization since his teenage years. In 1961 he founded Sinclair Radionics, after spending several years as assistant editor of Practical Wireless and Instrument Practice to raise funds. Sinclair has become a poker player. He appeared in the first three seasons of the late-night poker television series in Britain. He won the first season final of the Celebrity Poker Club. Sinclair had formed another company, initially called Able Steel Limited, in 1973. This changed name several times, eventually becoming Science of Cambridge Limited in July 1977. In June 1978, Science of Cambridge launched a microcomputer kit, the MK14, based on the national SEMP chip. By July 1978, a personal computer project was underway. When Sinclair learned the new brain could not be sold at below £100 as he envisaged, he turned to a simpler computer. In May 1979, Jim Westwood started the ZX80 project at Science of Cambridge. It was launched in February 1980 at £79 in kit form and £99 ready-built. In November, Science of Cambridge was renamed Sinclair Computers Limited. In March 1981, Sinclair Computers was renamed again as Sinclair Research Limited and the Sinclair ZX81 was launched at £49 in kit form and £69 ready-built, by mail order.
The machine's distinctive appearance was the work of industrial designer Rick Dickinson. Video output, as in the ZX80, was to a television set. Saving and loading programs was via an ordinary home audio tape recorder to audio cassette. Like its predecessor, it used a membrane keyboard. Timex Corporation manufactured kits as well as assembled machines for Sinclair Research. In the United States, a version with double the RAM and an NTSC television standard was marketed as a Timex. In both the ZX81 and ZX80, the video signal was generated largely by the Z80 chip itself. When the ZX80 ran a program, the screen blanked until the program paused for input or completed. The ZX81 improved on this by having two modes of operation, fast mode, blanking while programs ran, like the ZX80, and slow mode around 25% the speed. The ZX81 sold 1.5 million units, until it was replaced by its successor, the ZX Spectrum, which was capable of color graphics, sound, and a video signal generated without processor intervention.